Yes, everybody, welcome to a brand new podcast. I'm going to share this lovely moment in time. We are technology savvy. We have came a long time. Chinese had their technology before us, Americans and Canadians. But just remember, the Chinese have known this technology a long, long time. Now, the technology is more advanced. They're going to use thermal imaging. And guess what? Where they're going to use it? In grocery stores. Yes, folks. In grocery stores. Did I say twice? But this is the kicker. This is, as they say, the kicker to it. Thermal imaging. It has to do with hot and cold in people. Instead of passing through a front door of the grocery store, thermal imaging. It's not very much creepy, but I'm going to mention it here, and I'll title it. In my own way, a grocery store near you. So there you go, folks, a grocery store near you, thermal imaging, a grocery store near you. Yeah, that's right, near you. So there you go, folks, we are going to talk about this in Rebel News. I've mentioned it, I'll mention about that in Rebel News. Yeah, thermal imaging to a grocery store near you, as they say it like a theater kind of thing. So there you go. The next time you go to a grocery store in the city of Toronto, thermal imaging, folks. Thermal imaging. Did you get it? Did you hear it? Yes, I'll mention here in the title. Thank you very much. I want to say thanks to Rebel News for really, really emphasize this. Thermal imaging, nothing new. They've used this technology for quite a while, sometimes even in buildings. They use thermal imaging. They use the flare, or whatever it's called, flare imaging. It's the same thing as thermal imaging. Same thing, but way better. Way better, folks. Way better. So just like I said, thermal imaging, nothing new. We had it for at least 10 or 20 years. It's now come to grocery stores now. They're going to use it on the humans instead of the building. So there you go, folks. Thermal imaging, the grocery store near you.